My name is David Ewen, and this is Star Trek, The Interview. Our guests will include authors, actors, production staff, and contributors to Star Trek. Star Trek began in the 1960s, and since then has spawned multiple Star Trek television series, books, and movies. The interviews on this show will help define what good Star Trek is. My guest today is Dayton Ward, an author, and we will have a nice chat about the excellent work he has done.
Blog Talk Radio.
So let's be... And here we are. We're with Dayton Ward. My name is David Ewen. Dayton, how are you?
I'm doing fine. How are you?
Very good. I am looking at your website, which is your name. It's www.daytonward.com, daytonward.com. And on your website, DaytonWard.com, I scroll down, and we're going to talk about three books. There's Star Trek Vanguard, Star Trek Mirror Anarchy, and Star Trek Mirror Universe. But first, let's talk about what got you into writing Star Trek.
Well, I'm a lifelong fan of the show, particularly the original series. I grew up watching it, reruns after school, cartoons on Saturday, played with the toys, the whole nine yards. I started writing more as a hobby about 18 years ago. I was writing stories, including Star Trek stories, you know, my own fan fiction sort of thing. And I actually got started writing professionally by entering a contest that Pocket Books had put on back in 1997 called Strange New Worlds. It was a contest for amateur writers. I got a story selected for that first year anthology, and then I followed that on with the subsequent two anthologies, and at that point I was invited to write a novel for Pocket Books.
Let's talk a little bit about some of the work that you've done. What I'm looking, the first book on that I see listed here on the front page of your website is Star Trek Vanguard, and you wrote that yourself. Open Secrets, I think, is the subtitle.
Yes, the series name is called Star Trek Vanguard, and it is a series, it's a spin-off series that runs parallel to the events of the original five-year mission with Kirk, Spock, and Enterprise. But it has an entirely separate set of characters, takes place in a whole other section of space, and has its own core storyline. That is the fourth book in the series. The other, I wrote a previous installment in the series with my writing partner, Kevin Dillmore, that came out in 2006 called Summon the Thunder. And David Mack is another Star Trek writer who wrote the first and third books in the series. So we basically alternate. He writes the odd ones and we write the even ones.
And tell us a little bit about Star Trek Mirror Anarchy.
Mirror Anarchy was a six-book, or actually more of a novella, six-novella miniseries that was published in 2006 as a means of celebrating the 40th anniversary of the original show. Six different writing teams each took a novella, and we told a story with a through line of the Enterprise revisiting a particular planet over the course of the 30-year span of time that crew was together. We start off, you know, before the events of the original show, proceed through the five-year mission, the movie era, and then after Kirk's, you know, supposed death in Generations. They continue to revisit this planet over the years because it fell victim to a catastrophe early on, and then over the course of these 30-year span, they go back to see how, you know, to deal with the evolving situation as the world rebuilds itself.
And then another book I see on your website is Star Trek Mirror Universe, which I believe you're one of many people in that book. Is that correct?
Right. It's an anthology of short stories. What happened was in 2007, Pocket put out two trade paperbacks with three short novels each under the Mirror Universe label. Those did phenomenally well, so Pocket followed that up with this collection of short stories, which gets more of the different. Each of those original stories featured a different television show. So this book basically does some of the characters that didn't get face time in the other books and some of the spin-off novel-only series. So each of those stories is set in the Mirror Universe of the different shows. So you have like an alternate version of the Voyager crew and or DS9 characters or even some of the book series like New Frontier and Vanguard all get their chance to play.
Now, before we went on air, you had talked about you have seen the new movie directed by J.J. Abrams. Is that correct?
Sure have. In fact,
now, without giving any spoilers, As you mentioned, you're a fan of the original Star Trek series. What did you think of the new movie that just was released?
I enjoyed it. It's not the same thing as any Star Trek that I grew up with, but it's a slightly different take. It does take some liberties, but it's a lot of fun. It's going to be a great, in my opinion, a great summer movie. Definitely one of those summer blockbusters that they're looking for. It treats the source material with respect. It looks fantastic, sounds fantastic, moves very fast, and it's just an overall fun ride.
Well, that's good to hear. Dayton, I want to thank you for joining us on Star Trek The Interview and wish you luck on your future books. Now, you are working on another Star Trek book coming out in the future, aren't you?
I'm developing one right now. I really can't go into too much detail about it, but it will be, it'll come out either late 2010 or early 2011, depending on the schedule. We're still working out the kinks, and I really can't get too specific about plots or settings or anything like that at this point. Because nothing's been approved, so I'm sorry to have to play mysterious like that.
That's great, but we know that we have something to look forward to in the next year or two.
That and I'm sure that if the sales continue as they have, we will see. And I'll get to write another Vanguard book, probably for 2011. If the rotation goes the way it is, I should be working on another one here soon.
And we can find out all about it and reach you from your website, which once again is www.daytonward.com. That's DAYTONWARD.com. Once again, I want to thank you for joining us on Star Trek The Interview.
I want to thank you for having me. I appreciate it.